Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss how to find count of vowels and consonants in a given string. So let's create a new class. We'll name it as vowels and consonants. Take main method and then just finish. So how we are going to solve this problem is we'll have a set or list defined and we'll have all vowels defined in it. We know A, E, I, O, U are vowels, right? And English alphabets. So we'll have all these vowels defined in a set or a list, which is final. And then what we'll do is we'll actually go through each character in the given string and check if the current character is present in the set of vowels. If it is present, we'll increment the vowels count, or else we'll increment the consonants count. At the end of reading all the characters in the string, we'll just display the vowels count and consonant count. So first, let me define a set or a list. So I'll just define a set here, set of characters, where we'll define all the vowels in it. So we'll name this as all vowels, and then I'll have new hash set which actually holds all the vowels in it, A, E, I, O, U, right? So just import set from Java util package, hash set as well from Java util, arrays as well. All this comes from the Java util package. Now we have the all vowels set, right? So now what we'll do is we'll have an hard-coded string for now, where we'll define some string here. I'll have something called text tag 9. And then the first thing what we'll do is we'll convert all the characters. A character can be an uppercase or lowercase or mixed case, right? So we'll convert all the characters into lowercase. And then we need two variables to count the vowels and consonants count, right? So let's have two variables defined for that count, right? Next, what we'll do, we'll start reading the string character by character. So from the index 0, we'll read the string till all the characters are read. And we wanted to read each character, right? So let's store that in some char variable, string.char at my index. So we have the characters now from the string, right? Now we'll check the condition. If the character which we read from the string, is it vowel? How to find that is all vowels dot contains. So we have a contains method in the set. So we'll use that, which actually returns if the past parameter character is present in the set. If it is not present, it returns false. If it is present, it returns true. So ch is our character from read from the string, right? So if it is present, what we wanted to do, we wanted to increment the count of vowels. So we can't actually write it as else and increment the consonants count, as there can be numbers as well, right? So in like 0 to 9 are the digits, right? And you can even have a special character in a string or a white space, anything in a string, right? So we should not consider them as a consonant. So we should not write it as a else, but we should write a condition here and specify if the character is in between A and Z, right? CH less than or equal to Z. So why we are actually writing A to Z here is Java implicitly converts this character into its ASCII code, equivalent ASCII code, which is an integer. And the range of lowercase a to z is, the ASCII code range is 97 to 122, I guess. So Java implicitly converts each character into its ASCII code and checks if it falls within this range, 97 and 122. If it falls between that range, so it considers that as a consonant. And you can see why we are actually taking only lower cases. You can see we already converted the whole string into lower case. That's why we are having the condition on lower case characters from A to Z, right? So if this condition is true, then we are going to increment the consonants count. So once this loop is done, we'll have the count of both vowels and consonants. So we can just have this like this, vowels. We can just print it, vowels, and then the count of consonants. Consonants count. So let us run this program now. Run as the application. And we can clearly see here, there are two vowels in here, right? So E is one vowel and A is another one. So it says vowels two, consonants are seven. And you can see this nine is ignored. So it has like nine characters in it, excluding nine. And you can see it here. It clearly says vowels as two and consonants as seven. So if you want, we can even take another string and verify it. I give some ASCII here. You can see ASCII. AII are three vowels and consonants are two. So this is how we can find the count of vowels and consonants in a given string. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.